Have you journeyed to Kajistan before?
I rarely ventured beyond the bounds of Westmarch in my younger years. After the Order took me in, I had little need to travel.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is KageKaze back again with the Witch Doctor, ready to blow up some demons of hell. First, I'm trying to figure out what exactly my fetish is. I'm not sure I want to know. Look at that thing. It's kind of meh. Anyway, I've been looking forward to this. This sacrifice
Beyond
build is going to be fun.
Beyond these portals lie two relics that were once powered by my blood. Take the vials you recovered and use them to activate the relics.
I will stay here and prepare the ritual. Be careful. Even after everything we've come to know about Zoltun Kulle, I never imagined anything like this. Maybe Adria is right about the Black Soul Stone.
You doubted me. How disappointing.
Yes. We have reasons to doubt. I like taking the left first. Let's do that.
Angels are no better than demons. Did you know that they once voted on whether or not to eliminate all of mankind? Only one vote saved us from extinction.
I sense the hand of Tyriel in this.
Yes, whatever else he may be, he is the aspect of justice. And there is no justice in murder.
I think they all survived. That time none of them survived. That was awesome, though. I have a chance to get more dogs when things die, so I'm not worried. My cooldown is almost up as well. I honestly like the way this works. There we go. So I'm going to try using it more often, see if I can sustain it. Alright. I like the fact that even Zoltun Kulle, while he may have disagreements with Tyriel, respects him and what he is. Now normally this sand barrier here blocks projectiles, but it looks like Spirit Barrage actually goes through. That's nice to know. I really like this zone. Sand bridges, walls of sand.
Within me, the light grows stronger.
The lighting and just the overall ambience of this area. I'm trying to see if I can get my dogs back without casting it. There's dog number two.
Need more mama.
I'm losing dogs. Maybe I better use them. This build is not the most mana efficient, but with the Spirit is Willing rune, it isn't as bad as it could be. Technically, I have no primary mana regenerator on this build, so it's pretty much wait for the mana to come back, and if I need to hit single targets, I want to make sure I'm hitting with that barrage. Honestly, the book's flying out. There's a lot about this zone. It's very creative. This whole shadow zone or shadow realm thing allows them to kind of do different things. Unorthodox things. Well, while we're here, let's, okay. I don't have Leah anymore, so there's... can't talk to her. Alright, let's... boom. All but one of my dogs. And I got him back from killing. We're ready to go again. I really like this build because sacrifice takes, like, no mana. Alright, let's do the AoE. Hope that they can get closer to that elite. There we go. I think I just got vortexed. I completely missed it. I mean, just the sheer fact that you can take, like, the environment and destroy... Okay, hold on. I have to actually hit it. There. The environment gets destroyed, and then it reconstructs itself. This is by far one of my favorite places of Act 2. Probably second being the Oasis. I really think the Oasis is a very nice looking zone. A lot of nice art went into that. You know, even as much as I don't like the Desolate Sands and the desert in general, there is actually a lot of good art that goes into that too. I mean, if they were looking to make a scene that felt very desolate, they'd made it. And honestly, my dislike for it is not by their art. It's simply by the fact I just don't like the zone. I don't like that it is desolate. But I have to respect the fact that they could make it feel that way. Ooh. Avoid the fire. No, get into the fire. It gives you a buff. That's what I learned from World of Warcraft. Or at least people like to stand in the fire. I don't know. Whoa, why did it go there? Try again. Very good. These are fairly lengthy areas, so... Let's get moving. Of course, I'm on the long walkway, so it looks like I may have found the proper way to go, so that'll shorten time considerably. That's what I noticed about this zone. If you're on a long walkway, chances are you went the right way. So I honestly cut my travel time down quite a bit, just ended up having to go in just a straight line.
Golden Age, but my heroic brothers could not accept man's true destiny.
We will seal the Shadow Locks with vials of his blood, and we will hide the blood in the desert under eternal guard. I can only hope that the world does not forget Kul's eagle, and his blood remains undisturbed beneath the shifting sands.
Made that real quick, didn't it?
Chaldeum seems a treacherous city. Could it all be the result of the demons we pursue?
The power of corruption weighs heavily on their hearts.
We will free them from this heinous fate.
By all that is holy, do you see that enemy over
there? Do it! Okay. Get my dogs back. Make sure they're following an elite. We got knocked back. Come on, find one. There we go. And I still have three dogs. That's fantastic. 275 weapon damage across four dogs. Alright, one shadow locked down. To the other. Oh, that was just out of range, apparently. It's got a long range, but apparently it's not limitless. So I'm glad they re-added the ability for all these destructible items to actually drop items. That was something that was severely missing prior to this patch when they took it out. Just didn't feel right that you couldn't find a lot of items from destroying the environment. I ended up destroying the environment anyway because, you know, I liked to. I just like randomly destroying objects. I don't know why. Diablo allows me to fulfill that need. And now, not only does it allow me to fulfill that need, but it rewards me for doing it. So now I can go out into the real world, destroy stuff, and say, Diablo made me do it! Ah, yes. Sir. Penance lately for blaming bad behavior on video games, right? And movies and music and blah blah blah. Video games are not unique in that aspect, but they are unique in that I think they're more heavily persecuted. Mainly because they're interactive. Sorry, maybe do I need to pull out the soapbox? No, I think we'll leave it at that for now. Fez, right. I wear Fez now. Fez is a cool. And okay, right is not it, so we go left. And it looks like when I level, I'm going to be able to augment this build even further. I'm not going to have to get rid of it. I can just make it better. That is a lot of damage that Acid Cloud can put out. Look at that.
The spirit aid me.
Sometimes it's hard to tell what's my poison and what's the enemy's poison. Of course, there should be no poisonous enemies here, but if there were...
The truth burns you!
Need more time.
There we go. I just need to make sure I get relatively close to my opponents when they go to die, so I can proc Circle of Life. Well, I can resummon now, so I guess I don't need to worry about that. Let's just blow up what I've got. Resummon.
adversary.
Oh, here we go. Might have been a bit early. Probably should have waited until I could guarantee to hit more of them.
I have been healed.
You're good. Wasn't in any immediate danger, but wanted to use my jaunt anyway. I don't use Spirit Walk terribly often, but it's an excellent escape skill.
The Lord of Lies is as cunning as he is vile. We'll need to use our wits to defeat him.
Belial's deceit spreads.
I'm actually surprised that that faded out like that, considering it was my character talking. Interesting. Oh well, okay. North it is. You get those occasional audio glitches where something just sounds further off than it should. So right there, I think that barrier prevented me from popping the acid cloud beyond it. I'm going to try that again. So let's... Yes, it does. I can barrage past it, but I cannot acid cloud past it. Interesting. Those walls of sand can be quite annoying to most ranged classes. At least the Witch Doctor has a way to kind of circumvent it. Right. And everybody lives. Let's do it again. Almost everybody lives.
Events.
I know you. Even when you speak truly, the truth is hidden.
See, now I like the Witch Doctor's response to that. Every other character I've played pretty much says, well, of course, they're the last lords of hell. Of course they would do this. They orchestrated the whole thing. And yet, the Witch Doctor is smart enough to kind of sit back and say, well, even when you're telling me the truth, you're hiding something. You speak in half-truths. Which I think makes for the most interesting evil characters. Or even not evil. You know, there's a thing. There's a lot of debate on whether Zoltun Kulle was truly ever evil. If he was really the bad guy. It kind of comes back to that whole well-intentioned extremist personality type that he has. There are some of my favorite books that had the most intriguing characters were characters that could tell the truth. But even in telling the truth, they would be withholding just enough information to be able to manipulate other characters the way they wanted. See, what I'm noticing about this explosion here is that with enough enemies nearby, like that little ring summons quite a few little enemies. As long as I'm close enough to get my circle of life, which is only 12 yards, so I have to be mindful of that, then most of the time, I'll get them back. But between a 35% chance that they'll come back on their own and the 35% or 30% chance that what they kill will make them respawn. Pretty much all I have to do is stand close. So what I think I might want to do when I move towards in-game for one of the builds I'll consider is maybe just grabbing a whole bunch of improved radius for health globe pickup so that I don't have to be close in order to trigger Circle of Life.
Try as we might, Kul simply cannot be killed. His cursed blood sustains him. He bleeds sand and his laughter mocks us. There is only one course of action left to us. We will separate his body and his head and hide the body within the Shadow Realm.
So to get his body, we have to engage in card battles, right? Shadow Realm? Yu-Gi-Oh? Anyone? Ugh. Never mind. Last one. There it is.
This must be the Shadow Portal. Let us be done with this.
That is cool. Definitely not a Stargate, by the way.
The Horadrim did all this to lock my body away. They must have been very angry with me.
Are you surprised? Few people take betrayal lightly.
They were never very imaginative.
I don't know, man. Separating a man's head from his body and then bleeding out his blood and hiding them all in multiple locations seems fairly imaginative to me. Maybe I just live too sheltered of a life. Those little shadow beasts are fairly annoying. They love to swarm. Definitely one of the enemy types that I do not like running across. They're particularly nasty when you have a fight in Act 4 where there's a ton of them. Right at the very beginning of Act 4, no less. Okay. Come on, get close. Where am I? Sacrifice is not gonna work there. Well, could have worked there, but he was already nearly dead, so didn't need to use it. What have you got there, boys? What is it? A bone? Timmy's in the well? The summon's not too expensive. Okay, so I did level, so I really should put my skills on. So let's get to a point where, yes. Alright, let's look at what we got. I picked up about 3 skills for this level, I do believe. So, what we're going to do is trade out our Spirit Barrage and Acid Clow.
I can barely breathe.
First thing we got is Poison Dart, new rune, Spined Dart. Gain 23 mana every time a Poison Dart hits an enemy. So this pretty much is going to solve all my mana problems. Not only is it only... Well, basically, it's going from 8 mana cost to 23 mana gain, which means that is a massive mana boost. So we look at details here. I've got a 48 mana per second. Using this, that's 23. So it's going to be about 60 mana, probably more than 60 mana a second, actually. Let's go ahead and see if it has a special effect. Cool, that's nice. And it looks like it still maintains the 40% weapon damage over 2 seconds. So all it's really done, the poison dart, is just make it a very mana-efficient spell. So moving from there, the next thing we got is... Grasp of the Dead. So what I'm wondering is if I'm going to replace my Gargantuan or not. I'm kind of thinking of doing that, just so I can get something a little more mana-intensive. Because if I replace out my Cloud, I don't really have anything that uses a lot of mana, and therefore this build will be too mana-efficient. And that, by that I mean, I'm going to have so much mana, I'm going to be wasting it. I want to be able to effectively use my mana at the same time. We'll see how it goes as I go along, though. Grasp of the Dead, Death is Life, is great for this pet build. Because enemies who die in the area of Grasp of the Dead effect now have a 10% chance to produce a health globe or summon a zombie dog. This is something that changed in 104. In patches prior, all it was a chance to summon a zombie dog, and I do believe it was only a 5% chance, much like Circle of Life. It might have been 10, but I believe it was 5. But even then, now not only is it a higher chance, it's a zombie dog or a health globe. It used to only be zombie dogs, so Death is Life can be very useful in that regard. Now, because of this, okay, I don't have the passive for additional mana, that's fine. But what I'm wondering is, do I want Zombie Handle or do I want Circle of Life? Circle of Life... See, these are great. I kind of wish I had the third passive, because what I could do with the more mana now would be to... Let's see. I wouldn't really need anything here, but I don't really have anything I could offset it with. Well, I definitely don't need Spiritual Attunement, that's for sure. Alright. Well, the Gargantuan looks like he is actually going to go away. He's going to go away to Big Bad Voodoo. And that's kind of a shame, because I think he would work well with the Voodoo. I could actually replace my Jaunt and have two of these massive cooldown abilities. But of course, Gargantuan stays alive for quite a while. I might do that, actually. I haven't been needing to use my Jaunt. Let's do that. Hold on. Let's do that. I'll change it up a bit. I haven't been using it. Let's do more than one big guy. This is 120 seconds, so a 2-minute cooldown. Conjure a fetish that begins a ritual dance that increases the attack speed and movement speed of all nearby allies by 20%. So that is fantastic. So what I'm going to do is I think I'm going to move around my dogs in that so I don't... No, I think that'd be fine. Middle for the dance. So with this build, the question is... Do I really need to have this additional mana? I want to keep the sacrifice build intact here. Oh, that's nice. Look at that. A green effect. See, what I want is... You know what? I want Gruesome Feast. If I'm going to have a chance to get health globes, and that increases my intelligence, I think I want to do that. So, what do I do? Do I keep the Gargantuan? Do I put something on here that's a little more AoE-oriented? I could go back to using the Cloud. Alright. Let's do this. We're going to go back to using the Cloud. We're going to put Grasp of the Dead on my 4, so that's the one I'm more comfortable with. My Cloud can go on my secondary attack. And I've got... There we go. Alright, so instead of... I think it's Zombie Handler I'm going to get rid of, because this will still give me my dogs back. I don't need the fourth dog. I'll do Gruesome Feast, give me more intelligence for health globes. So this should give me more health globes to get my intelligence up. I'm going to be fairly mana efficient now. I've got my Acid Cloud being my high-end mana spender. But as you can see, I'm going to put this down, and I'm just going to start firing. Oh, it's only when it hits an enemy. So it's not like a Demon Hunter where I can just cast it and not hit anything. I actually have to hit something. That shouldn't be a hard thing to do. So if it doesn't hit an enemy, it still technically costs the mana as listed. Let's try this out. I like the fact that I've continued to do my pet build by having my Grasp of the Dead help me get more dogs. So I've got Circle of Life giving me 30, Grasp of the Dead giving me 10, and I've got the Sacrifice Rune itself giving me another 35% chance of getting dogs back. I should have a near endless supply of dogs.
I strike at your heart.
Alright, let's get through this Shadow Realm. So far, nothing being a big threat.
There is no sun in this world. I can feel it. Outside these walls is a land of eternal night.
Well, they do call it the Shadow Realm. What did I miss? Looks like right there. Right then, a little back and forth never hurt anybody, right? Make sure that's okay. Very good. Lots of AoE death going on here.
Your evil undoes you.
With the added ability to slow, snare. I'm just thinking I could make this an even bigger AoE build with the cloud, the grass, and locusts. Get him. Brilliant. I should have put the, I really should have put the grasp under him to try and get more, or try and get a chance at dogs there. I'm very happy that they changed those explosion animations there. You can actually see where they're going to blow up now.
You do not trust me. I understand. But we are more alike than you know. We have both tasted what it is to be Nephilim. Join with me, and we can become the masters of this world.
I have joined with you as much as I please to.
Wasn't that 6 I just picked up? Oh well. Guess it didn't play. Maybe it was 5.
I have retrieved Kul's body from the realm of shadow.
Then let me begin the ritual. But I'm warning you, Kul. You'd better not cross us.
You are surrounded by deceit, young one. I am the least of your concerns. Concentrate, Leah. Soon now. Just a bit longer. Just a moment. Almost. Yes. Thunders within me. This fetid air fills my ravaged lungs. I am alive again.
You're welcome.
You are whole again, Zoltun. Now, give us the soul stone.
Very well. The bargain stands. Quickly, to my sanctum.
You should follow Kul into his sanctum before he changes his mind.
Indeed, and we shall.
At long last, I can complete my life's work. All will tremble at my power. What is this? Happened. The souls of the dead lords of hell have been absorbed into the stone. Abandon your quest, Nephilim. Your allies seek only to control you. With the power I offer, you and I could rule over all creation.
You are mad, Kul. Give me the stone, or I will destroy you.
Well, that was fun to put down my voodoo and cast quickly. Oh, look at this. I've got a bunch of intelligence now. That worked. Admittedly, Big Bad Voodoo is not really good for this build, since it's majorly a attack speed increase. It's more designed for a build that's used to spam spells more. Although I did use it, and I could spam my acid cloud, but still not the best way to use it. And honestly, Big Bad Voodoo probably would have been better with the Gargantuan, maybe, since the Gargantuan would have kept attacking faster.
Have been triggered. It seems my brothers have finally come looking for me. Damn them. I am not ready. Too much of my power is invested in the stone's creation. I must finish it. The future of mankind depends on it.
Hmm.
5 lords of hell now reside within this stone. Adria, you must tell us the whole truth of the stone.
20 years ago, during the darkening of Tristram, Cain told me of Zoltun Kulle's profane soul stone.
That's why you left me. You went to mark the demon's souls so that they could be drawn into Kulle's vessel.
Yes, my daughter. I have sacrificed everything for this.
Okay, so now for one of the other major changes that's very nice, being able to teleport out of Kulle's chamber. So here we have the interesting topic of discussion and why a lot of people side with Kulle. Is that Kulle recognizes that you're being betrayed. Recognizes that you're being manipulated.
Very bad luck, hasn't it?
And he pretty much offers you the chance to turn away from, you know, to change the tide. It's like, look, things are happening, you're being manipulated. I want you to work with me, and we can rule together. Now, granted, Kulle's aim to rule is far from noble. Far, far from noble. But he at least offers you that chance. So let's see what we've got here. Looks like I've got some new pants. It's going to be an upgrade. Let's put those on. Actually, half kind of pants here. So let's go get rid of that. I've got armor. Not going to use that. Not going to use that. So anything under 35 DPS will probably be going away, especially two-handers. No. Two-handed with 25? No. Bow? No. Well, so far, nothing really good. Ooh, here we go. 5 to 7, more vitality. I lose a little bit of damage for the life. No, I won't use that one. And same intelligence, better magic, fine, less armor, that's fine. Fairly even trade. Strength, better chance of magic, fine. Nope, wizard anyway. Let's see, 40 with strength dex. Ooh, it's got intel on it though too, so the strength and dex are fine. Strength will give me more armor. Monster kills grant experience. It says I lose a little bit of damage, but I honestly think it's worth it in the long run, so we'll do that. And I don't think I'm going to use this. I could put some intelligence into it. Well, maybe I will. We'll see. Look at this. Vitality, attack speed, hit adds life, magic find, critical chance, and an empty socket. I think we'll upgrade these. Let's take a look at that. Alright, so I went ahead and did a little bit of gem crafting off the side here so you didn't have to worry about seeing it and get bored watching me fiddle with inventory screens all day long. What I was able to do here, though, is combine some of my gems, and now I've got flawless gems. I got a flawless ruby here, and I've got flawless topazes here. They're making this gear a little better for me. As you can see, now I have 150 DPS. I've put it into my dagger here. I went ahead and put some topazes into these armor slots for more intelligence. So you can see here, this will give me 10 DPS with a loss of 0.7 protection. If I do it in the off, I would lose damage but gain life and protection. So it looks like it would be a better replacement for the left ring. So let's do that. And this is going to make me lose quite a bit of life, 270, but I'm going to gain 10.4 damage and 0.6 protection. So that will help out. Let's just go ahead and put that on. Oops, that's leggings, actually, not armor. Let's put that on. Oh my, they are golden color. Let's just make it match, shall we? Not that that's the best color in the world for this set, but hey. I feel pretty. Oh, so pretty. Okay, this has got vitality and attack speed. Can I possibly increase Cormac's DPS with this? Let's find out. He's at 16.18.
Excellent.
Nope, that goes down.
Good thought.
Nope. So match for the raw strength. Alright. So what we'll do is we'll go to Squirt, and we'll get rid of these. I also changed the build up just a tiny bit. I'm going to use Zombie Charger now instead of the Acid Cloud. It's a little less mana, does more damage in a single shot, and it is better combined with the Big Bad Voodoo, I think. So, for example, if I put down the Voodoo and I start one.
I need mana.
I think that'll work. Look at that guy. Crazy.
What will we do when we've trapped Belial and Asmodan in the Soul Stone?
Then I will shatter it, and the Lords of Hell will be no more.
We've got to reach the Emperor. He said he can lead us to Belial.
Are you certain we can trust the child?
We have no choice, but know this. If Belial gets desperate, he will unleash hell upon Chaldeum.
So before we face him, we must evacuate the citizens. The Iron Wolves can help.
Leah is right. Let us go.
Before I go too further
hey,
here.
Mister, I got some new things. You should take a look.
We have the Black Soul Stone at last, despite Zoltun Kulle's betrayal. I always knew he couldn't be trusted. Fortunately, we were able to defeat him and retrieve the stone. I learned that my mother had secretly bound the fallen lords of hell to it. I just wonder why she didn't tell me.
Ah, important questions indeed. And just kind of looking at the scenery here, you know, honestly, Chaldeum looks pretty nice from here. Even if it's not truly a 3 days more of a painting, but hey, it looks good.
Belial has started his attack on the city. Let's go. Ashira is already at the sewers.
Alright, oh!
Hurry! We'll keep you safe!
Belial knows we come for him. He will destroy this city to stop us.
When the fireballs began falling from the sky, we started evacuating the people. They will be safe here.
We will save all that we can.
The Iron Wolves will assist you to the death.
I saw people hiding under the carts. Bring them to the sewers.
We can't risk our lives on this foolish...
Alright, we're gonna move fairly quickly here. Let's save as many as we can. Oh, Moan over here. The poison cloud from my zombie charger is working out pretty nicely, actually. And the dogs. The dogs are... Ooh, splat. Couldn't get to them in time. Let's go, go, go! As long as I can get here, it should count them all. Whole bunch of experience. And plenty of gold, no less. Come along, Patsy. Saving you from the dying town. Stop killing the people I'm trying to protect.
We have nowhere to hide.
Don't stand in the circles.
Watch out! Keep the people away from those fireballs.
Did I miss someone? I did. Come on.
It's safe now to the gates. We have no time to lose.
Let's go.
Now, Leah, use your power just the way I taught you and bring down these gates.
Stand back. I still can't fully control it.
Mr. Gorbachev, bring down this wall!
The power of hell cannot save you!
We've finish them off.
Alright, looking good, looking good. Haven't needed the voodoo. Also, the zombie charger is doing quite a nice job of it, isn't it? Wow. Part of that's got to be the additional gems, the ruby and the topaz. Yeah, the changes to the gem system, the only use two gems for early level stuff, made it real easy to get all of my stuff leveled up. That's it.
Kill him.
Alright. So I didn't even use my sacrifice on that one. I just killed him with zombie chargers. Alright, well, since I won't have the voodoo for the next group, I'll probably just blow up the dogs on that one. Does quite a bit of damage on its own, then of course there's the acid trail. Come along, dogs. Wow. They all survived for two uses.
Again, daughter. I feel so weak. I don't know if I can.
You must! Now! It is up to you now. Hurry! I must stay here and tend to Leah.
Pushes her hard.
Praise the gods, you've arrived just in time. Show me the Soul Stone.
It shall be your prison for all eternity, Belial. You will see more of it than you want to.
Clever. But know this, Nephilim. Asmodan knows of the stone and the power it contains. Even if you defeat me, he will exterminate you and every last one of your misbegotten kind.
Hakana's Belial? What? What madness is this? Who saw that coming? It's pretty bad that I actually saw that coming from the beginning the first time around. I think many people did.
I will not be undone! This world is mine!
I do like how Hakan's voice starts to reverberate in the background prior to him turning.
I cast off these petty illusions. The true vision of the Lord of Hell!
Let's do this! Alright, that is really cool. Even if he couldn't lie his way out of a paper bag, he knows how to look damn cool. Still pulling up dogs. Uh-oh. Out of that. Oh. Yeah, they have a larger radius than it looks like it does. Okay, let's get the dogs up. Roll them up. Looks like they didn't survive. Not bad. Quite a bit of damage going out on that one. Further difficulty levels, I think I'm going to have to be very mindful of him doing his damaging attacks, his melee swings and whatnot, because those will hurt me later on. So thankfully, I'm able to take them right now.
Quickly, Leah. Seal Belial's soul within the stone.
It is ironic that one as twisted as Zoltun Kulle played so great a role in our salvation.
Kulle was once a tireless enemy of Hell. From his life, let us learn. The longer we fight evil, the more it can corrupt our hearts.
All right. We are done. Belial is dead. It's time to move on to Asmodan. Let's take a look at our loot before we do that, shall we? Fortunately, one of them is a wizard's helm. Not very good. So let's see, we've got some chest armor here with some vitality. Same vitality as what I have, I lose the experience. No, I don't actually, I gain one there at the very end. Okay, so it's already an upgrade. It's loss of one armor, but same vitality, one more experience, and it's got magic find on it. How can I possibly say no to that? Don't even see a color on it. Ah, well. A voodoo mask with intelligence, huh? More armor. Some intelligence. I'm only really using the headpiece for experience gain, so I gain damage but lose life, and I lose protection. I don't think it's enough of a change. One thing I'm going to do, though, I think, is put a flawless if I have one. So what I might do is take the flawless out of here and put it in here, just to make the experience gain a little better. So what do I have on Cormac? I have a 27 DPS weapon. Do I have anything better? That's a two-hander, it's a 28, I have a 37. I can give him that. Alright, the shoulders, intelligence and magic find. Lose 40 life for 5.7 damage. Yeah, I can do that. I lose protection as well, even though it doesn't show it. Probably because the intelligence will be giving me my resistances. Let's just real quick do that. That usually kicks it in. Nope. We're fine then. I think I'll take the intelligence for a little more damage. And the magic find. Yeah, let's do that, because I would really like to try and find some kind of... I really think I'd like to find some kind of, like, maybe even a legendary. That would be nice in this early level, but we'll have to see. This has monster kills grant experience. Has a little more damage, 4 to 5 compared to 3 to 4. Loses intelligence, though. In the end, it'll give me additional damage, but I'll lose a little protection. That's fine. I can deal with that. So those are going away. This is going away. That's going away. Oh, hello. 23 intelligence and 8% magic find. Pure upgrade. Let's put that on. Oh, look at that. Spiky. That's cool looking. And a keen heavenly axe of the angels, 22.5. Sorry, but no. Alright. Very quick, before we call this act, let's just go ahead and do this with our gems here. Let's... Wow, 1,040 for that, huh? Actually, what was that? That was a square. That's actually better than what I was going to put in there. I have a flawless square, though, from my last... So I'm gonna go ahead and do that, I think. I'll go ahead and put that in here. That is like the one item I'm gonna use that I would normally not have access to in this difficulty level. I won't put the square ruby in the weapon. I'm gonna stick to the flawless, which I could reasonably have a flawless at this level. Just because they changed the way this all works. Actually, I could probably make it one now. I could turn those chipped into a flawed and then the flawed into a regular, and yeah. So on and so forth as it goes. So, actually, let's do that because I'm going to need to put one of these in Cormac's weapon that I'm going to be using. Oh, 186 DPS. Alright, so really fast, let's do this. We'll turn the chipped into a flawed into a ruby. We're going to take that ruby, put it into this weapon, and give it to Cormac. This is a 39.9 now. It actually beats out the one I'm using. But the one I'm using has mana regeneration, so I'm not worried about gaining the extra damage. I'm going to go ahead and give this to Cormac. He's doing 16.8. He will now do 23.3. So I'll keep my regeneration, even if it is only 3 per second. Excellent. Why am I holding on the amethyst? I just realized that.
Today is a good day. You have liberated this land and brought low a lord of hell. Enjoy this moment, for tomorrow our war continues.
There is no time for rest. Even now, Asmodan plots our destruction.
The Lord of Sin is an uncanny tactician. He'll attack us where he believes we'll least expect it.
And where defeat would break our will to resist.
You are learning well, Leah. Now you must go to Chaldeum's Great Library and continue with your uncle's work.
I can be ready to leave at a moment's notice. Let me know when you are prepared to go.
And now we move on to Act 3. One of my favorites.
Choose to hide it.